The winds were really strong. It was extremely dry, extremely hot, and the fire made a really big run. Our old house was located near Sheep Creek. The creek runs through kind of a narrow valley. The winds blew the fire down that narrow valley where our house was located and burned the house down that way. It was absolutely devastating. My sister describes losing the house as losing a person. It was as if the house had its own biography. My family's been connected to this land for six generations, almost 130 years. We were camping out in this meadow over here. It had started kind of spitting rain, and then it started lightning. We saw water running down the road. We followed it up and realized that Sheep Creek was experiencing a flash flood. And it had completely jumped its banks and was flowing over the foundation of our old house. Sheep Creek is the next watershed below Black Hollow, downstream of Black Hollow. There had been a massive catastrophic debris flow at Black Hollow that pushed six homes into the river and killed four people.
It was just a normal July rain, nothing unusual about it. It wasn't real heavy. And I looked down and there was about a foot and a half of mud and water going across the patio. I put on some rubber boots and trudged my way across what was flowing and made my way up the mountain a little ways where I could look at the creek coming down, and was blown away by the creek that's normally a foot deep and 5 feet wide is now 15, 20 feet deep and 25, 30 feet wide. And all this rock and debris is just flowing down, and it's all just black water. As I was making my way up the mountain, I saw Dick Brown's house going down the river. I saw the firefighter, my fellow volunteers, I'm a volunteer firefighter up here. They were driving up and down the canyon trying to figure out, you know, what was going on and where people were. The loss of life and the loss of houses and loss of 60 years of my life. You know, I grew up here, and I grew up coming up here, and to see the devastation, not only from the fire, but from the flood. It's devastating, and it'll never be back, at least I don't think in my lifetime I'll ever feel like it's back to some semblance of normalcy.
When we arrived on scene at Black Hollow then in Poudre Canyon, that was probably one of the most humbling experiences I've had as a scientist, knowing what had happened at the site and that people had actually lost their lives. It really hit home to me the importance of what we're doing and really trying to, you know, get the best possible answers that we can get so that those types of things don't happen in the future. Chaffee County is 4 hours south of Poudre Canyon. We did a pilot project to model and map where post-wildfire debris flows could potentially occur ahead of the wildfire, and then assess what the risk of those debris flows might be to infrastructure and buildings in Chaffee County. Debris flows are very dangerous landslides that start in mountainous topography and run out over long distances. Fire makes the ground hydrophobic or impervious to water. Moderate rainfall can't be absorbed by the soil, so the water stays on the surface, and that can be enough to cause a debris flow. We could help the county in terms of prioritizing which areas are most prone to these types of events, and then helping them develop planning and solutions to deal with those particular hazards. We have the capability to also help, you know, communities find the funding that they need to be able to support that type of mitigation. DebrisFlow Predictor is a two-dimensional modeling software that allows us to model shallow landslides, including debris flows and post-wildfire debris flows. Where is a debris flow most likely to initiate? And then once we understand where those locations are, then we run a very large number of debris flow runout scenarios as the debris flows come out of the watersheds and into valleys. It allows us to look at like how that flow might change its location over time, and then we can assign a likelihood of that debris flow occupying a particular space in time that then informs our risk analysis.
This watershed is really important for hundreds of thousands of people, most of whom do not live in the Poudre Canyon. So the flood mitigation work that was done on these tributaries to the Poudre River and the Poudre Canyon not only benefited families like mine and other private landowners, but that work also benefited the users of that water downstream. We also situated our new house in the least hazardous place possible on our land. We have a more realistic understanding of the kinds of geological processes that can occur on this landscape.
I'm happiest when I'm up here. I feel close to just my history. I feel close to the community. We have a pretty close-knit community up here. It's my home. It's always been my home.